In this video, I want to show you how to add grid and coordinates to map in QGIS. So let's get started. In QGIS, I have my map already prepared. So if you want to take it to layout, add your grid and make the coordinate to show. So let me show you how to do it. To do that, come to Project. Then click on New Print Composer. So you can just give it a name, let's call it map 1 for instance, and click on OK. So when it opens, the first thing to do is to draw a frame here to make your map look neat. So to do that, come to layout, or in other versions you may see add item. Click on layout and here you will see add shape. So click on add rectangle. So draw your rectangle like this. Then you can edit the rectangle by clicking on the style. Then click on simple fill. Scroll down and increase the outline width, let's say to 1.5 for instance, and click on OK. Yes. So we can lock it. Then here we go. Let's add the map. To do that, come to layout and click on add map. So you can also see it here, add map. So once you click like that, it will pick the icon. Just come here and draw your map. Just like this. So you can equally adjust your map if you are not satisfied with the size. Then the next thing to do is to zoom in our map to cover the whole map area. So to do that, pick this icon, which is move item content. So click and move it. Then you can now zoom in to the size you want. You can do that, hold your control key and zoom to the extent of the map. So we can just click and move a little bit. Yes, this is okay. Then the next thing to do is, as it is highlighted, move down and let's do the major work, which is adding grid. Come to grids, click to expand it, then click on this plus icon to add a new grid. So the new grid has been added as grid 1. So now select the grid type. I want it as solid. If you want it as cross, markers or frame and annotation only, you can choose any one here, but let's leave it as solid. Then the interval here, you can choose it either to be in millimeter if you want your grid to be in millimeter, or to be in map units or centimeter. So I want it to be in map units, so I'll select map units. Then the interval, I want it to be, for example, 0.8. Then here also the y interval, 0.8, that is 0.8 is in decimal degree. This 0.8 is in decimal degree. However, hasn't been I choose millimeter, I will have entered my interval as millimeter. So after doing that, then you can equally change the line style here. So if you are satisfied with the style, just click, just move down and click on draw coordinates. You can see coordinate has been drawn. However, we can still adjust it. So choose the format here. If you want it to be in decimal degree as it is, you can leave it. However, I want it to be in degree, minute, seconds with suffix. So I'll just click on that and you can see it here. Then another thing I can do is to change the font. To do that, scroll down and you will see font here. click on font. So choose your font style, and then here I want it to be bold and I want the size to be 14. Click on that and click OK. So you can see it here. However, you can see that the one at the right side and the one at the right, at the left hand side are outside my frame. So what I can do is to come back here under this left and right. So this horizontal, I'll click here and choose vertical ascending. You can see it has been changed. Then the right hand side also, I want this horizontal to be vertical ascending. You can see it also. So the next thing is I can scroll up and come to the grid frame. So the frame style, instead of no frame, I can choose to put zebra. You can see it here, it has been inserted. Then I can also change the color. So the frame fill colors, let me change it to red, for example. So you can see it here. So you can see that I've been able to add grids and also add coordinates to my grid in QGIS. So if you are satisfied with everything, you can lock it. And here we go. So we can now export our map. And to do that, let's export it as image. Click here to export as image. So I want to save it as, for example, let me just A. Then here I have to choose my format. So I want it to be JPEG, and you can also choose PNG. So let's go with JPEG and click on save. Then here, choose your export resolution. Let's make it 500. The higher the resolution, the clearer the image, and also the higher the size. So click on save. Then we can now go to that folder, and here is it A. So you can see the size is about 1 MB. So let's click to open it. And here is our map. So you can see this is how to add grids and also coordinates to map in QGIS. If you like this video, give us like and make comments. Thank you for watching.